Good morning, class 6. Today, our topic is friction is a necessary evil. Why is this called so? Why do we say frictional force is a necessary evil? What does it mean? That means even if it has certain disadvantages, evil, that means it's harmful, it's not useful, but there are few cases or there are certain instances in life where we cannot do without friction. That's why friction is needed also. It's necessary. So that's why it's an interesting phrase, you know. Friction is a necessary evil. So we know that it's not useful or it's not advantageous sometimes, but still it's a necessary thing in our daily life. Let's see friction, why we call friction as a necessary evil. Okay, so we will start first with why do we call it evil, that means what are the disadvantages of friction. Let's see the points. Friction produces heat. You will find this that when you rub your hands, we say that when we feel very cold, you will find a general tendency that we rub our hands when we feel cold. Why do we do so? Because by rubbing our hands, we can actually feel some heat. You will notice that, right? That is because when we rub our hands, what is happening? Frictional force is taking place. Friction is produced when we rub our hands against each other. We are moving our hand over another hand. So, friction produces heat then. Friction is such a... You will find as you grow, that means you will go to the higher classes, you will learn about the different more consequences. Okay. So, this is just a daily life example which I gave you, that this you will... Definitely, you would have found that when you rub your hands, you will find that you are actually getting warmer. That is because by rubbing our hands, we are producing friction. Because one hand is moving over another hand, that's why. As a result, friction actually can produce heat. When there is a lot of friction, we find that heat is produced. Now you find that suppose the fast moving machine produces large amount of heat. Now if while the machine parts when they are moving, if after say they are working for several years and or say even several days or months, each and every day friction is being produced while they are moving, and gradually with time each and every day some amount of heat energy is produced, and at one day you will find that the machine parts is getting damaged. Why? Because excessive amount of heat will damage the machine parts. So that's why often we arrange something for cooling down. That means so that the heat is absorbed by something. We make certain arrangements. You will find that if you ask your parents, in the radiators of the cars, we use certain things so that we can try to cool down the heated machine parts. Why is it cooling done? So that excessive amount of heat is not produced and the machine parts is not damaged. Okay, so learn this, that friction produces heat, and as a result it can damage the various moving parts of a machine. Friction produces wear and tear. You will find that after prolonged use of shoe, you will find the sole of the shoe getting damaged. Why? Because every day we are walking with the same shoe, and you will find that obviously after many days the sole will get damaged. Why? Because every day it's being used over some rough surface. Every day it's exposed to friction, and friction therefore we can say it produces wear and tear, that is damage. See, it wear and tear on the surfaces in contact. So that's why It can damage us along with the machine parts also, the shoe soles. Third point, see, a lot of energy is wasted due to friction. Why do we say so? Because, you know, just an example which I give, say, if suppose, actually in the, you know, when the friction is more, what will you find? You will have to apply more and more energy is wasted to overcome the force of friction. Then in order, say, a bus is moving or a car is moving, if there is a lot of friction, if suppose, for example, it's a very bumpy road, there will be a lot of friction, then very rough surface. So the car or bus will have to actually spend a lot of energy to overcome the force of friction. So that is why at certain times we need some ways so that we can reduce the friction. We can reduce the friction. So there comes the part reducing friction. Why we need to reduce friction? A lot of time, energy and money is wasted in overcoming the friction and its effects in our daily life. So these are the methods. Number one, providing wheels or ball bearings. See, an example of ball bearings is given. I'll give you an example why they are used or how they are used. Why, what are ball bearings? Simple case, you will find that in trolleys or suitcases, the last day I've explained. Why do we give the rollers or this kind of metallic balls? Why? Because so that you find that it's difficult, or it's rather more easy to roll a thing rather than slide a thing. That is because rolling friction is less than sliding friction. Also, in various machine parts, ball bearings or this small metallic balls are there. Why are they used? Because they are used between the two moving parts of a machine to reduce the friction. And if friction is reduced, what will happen then? Movement will become much easier, because friction is the one which opposes the motion, we know. Okay. Then is oiling or lubricating. You will find that if you have found these machines in your home used by your grandparents, you will find that they sometimes at time to time they apply some oil. In order, why is oil used? Because to make the surface smoother. Oily surface is smoother than any. Suppose you have a oil, you throw some oil on the floor. You will find the floor will get more slippery, isn't it so? So you will tend to fall more on the slippery floor. Which if you have thrown oil, you will tend to fall more rather than it's simply a floor where there is no oil. So oil, by applying oil, we can actually reduce the roughness of the surface, and that is why they are used to decrease, to reduce the friction. Next is polishing. Polishing means it's another way to decrease the roughness of a surface, and as we decrease the roughness, we decrease the friction, because we have learned, right? You remember, friction depends on the nature of the surface. More the surface is rough, more is the friction. Next is streamlining. What is streamlining? You don't have to go through all this. Listen to me first. You see the aeroplane? There are different bodies which are given certain shapes. You know, while making aeroplanes, it's kept in mind that aeroplane has to be designed in such a way that the friction by the air, aeroplane moves in air, you know, the air also provides friction. When the aeroplane moves in air, the air also tries to oppose the motion of the aeroplane. Then what do we call that friction? Fluid friction. Friction given by any fluid. Fluid means it can be liquid or it can be gas. Water, if suppose I move a body in water, water will also provide friction, that will be friction due to water. Similarly, this kind of aeroplanes are given certain shapes such that they will face minimum frictional force due to air, because you imagine you are flying in an aeroplane and the aeroplane cannot move. Why? The pilot say that lot of air friction is there. So you will scream at the pilot, right? So it's not done. So we need certain ways so that air friction is reduced and the aeroplane can move much comfortably, isn't it? So that's streamlining. Now, for your exam, you don't have to learn all this. Learn the names of the processes. Learn the names. Number one, providing wheels or ball bearings. Number two, oiling or lubricating. Number three, polishing. And number four, streamlining. Okay? Just learn the names then. I hope you can do this. Learn the disadvantages of friction also. Okay? All the points. Now, next we move on to why we call it a necessary evil. That means, what can be the advantages of friction? Let's see. See, remember this also I have told you. Friction helps us in walking. You don't have to read this part. In the absence of friction, we may slip or fall. If suppose, you will find this, that if a floor is very slippery, you will find it difficult to walk properly. You will tend to sleep all the time because friction is less. Isn't it interesting that friction helps us in walking? So that is why it's difficult to move on a weight or a very smooth and polished floor, because friction is less. Friction is more when the surfaces are rough. Smooth surface, less friction. Cars and buses are able to move safely on roads. You imagine cars and buses, if they try to move on a very slippery floor, what will happen? They will not be able to move because the roads are a bit rough, and also the tires, you will find that the tires are made in such a way that the surfaces are not much polished, or it's not much, even or smooth. They are given grooved designs. I'll show you in the next page what are grooved designs, so that this friction between the surface of the road and the tires will be increased. If friction is increased, that means we want the friction to be there. It's true that we don't want such an amount of friction that will not allow the car to move, but also we need some amount of friction so that the cars or vehicles won't slip while they try to move. Leave this point. Next, see, friction allows us to hold object with our hands. You will find, suppose if you try to get hold of something on where oil is applied, you will find that your hand will slip. If you try to hold, say, any object, say, on which oil is applied before, you will find that your hand will slip often. Why? Because the surface is very smooth and there is no friction. So your hand will actually slide very fast. That's why it will slip. Friction allows us to therefore hold object with our hands. That means if I want to hold this pencil bag, I will be able to hold. My hand won't just slide away. I'll be able to hold it. Okay. If suppose I want to move my hand over this, I'll be able to move as I wish. If suppose this was very slippery and there was no friction, if I would have just wanted to hold it like this, my hand would have slipped. Because if there is no friction, then it's very difficult to control the motion. Friction allows us to write on paper. You imagine you're trying to write on glass or polythene where the surface is very smooth. Each time you will find pen will slip due to absence of friction. How can we write on paper? Because it has got some amount of roughness, which is sufficient to provide the required amount of friction needed to write on paper. Another interesting thing, matchstick. How do we actually light the matchstick? When we light the matchstick by rubbing it against a matchbox, what happens? The friction is developed. Frictional force. Because you're rubbing a matchstick against a matchbox. So friction. Now, as we have learned, friction produces heat, and if there is a lot of friction, it can also produce light energy. So we are able to light a matchstick. The matchstick is made in such a way that it will catch fire. The matchstick is made in such a way that due to this, even a very small amount of heat energy is produced, it can easily catch fire, right? Okay. So just see, there are few cases we need to increase friction then. This was the one I was talking about. See the designs of the tires. See, this is called grooved designs. And also on the shoes, the back of the shoes, you won't find the back of the shoes to be very slippery or smooth. Have you found ever the back of your shoes very slippery? No, you won't be able to walk then. You will always find the back of the shoes a bit rough or made in these designs, because this is done so as to increase the friction. And you can grip on the road. Your shoes can hold a grip on the road. Otherwise, each time you try to walk, you will fall. You will find that this is the reason spikes are provided in the sole of the shoes used by sports person to increase the friction so that they get a firm grip on the ground. Also, when the road is very wet or muddy, you will find when you will try to walk wearing slippers, you have a tendency to fall, because the slippers, their surface is the back surface of the shoe, it's not that rough. That is why, or rather, spikes are not provided there. That's why you don't get a grip on the ground. That is why you have a tendency to fall, because it can easily slide over the ground and you will fall. But if you have spikes, it can actually get a firm grip on the ground then. Okay. Handles of motorbikes are covered with a rough towel or spiked rubber. This you have seen many times. Why is it same thing? When you are trying to hold the handles, you imagine it's made of oiled surface. What will happen? You will never be able to hold. Every time you try to hold them, your hand will slip, because at that time friction is less. So why is it done? In order to provide some certain amount of friction so that you can hold the handles. Wrestlers often rub a special substance on their hands before wrestling sessions, so that obviously they don't want that when they are trying to fight with someone, if their hand keep on slipping over their opponent's body, it's not desirable. So they rub a special substance so that which increase the friction. That means they will be easily able to hold someone's body when they are fighting. Okay, so these are the increasing friction ways, and learn the advantages of friction which I have marked. Okay, so that covers advantages and disadvantages of friction.